Good afternoon, children. Welcome to online classes. I am Jilakara Srinivas, School Assistant Biological Science, ZPHS, Tirumalagiri, Surapet District. And we are learning about various types of animal tissues from our previous classes. Today we are going to discuss about the various types of muscular tissues and nervous tissue. Okay, my dear children. Before going to discuss about the topics, just to think about the questions and give reflection to the questions. How the animals move their body? During winter, our body shivers. Why? What happens if the muscle of heart is stop beating? How do you feel if you put your fingers in a glass of hot water or cold water? Why we can't start or stop the muscles present in the blood vessel or in alimentary canal? These are the questions we are going to bring answers in this period. Okay, my dear students, here learning outcomes of this lesson are: the learner write the differences between striated muscles and non-striated muscles. The learner give examples for various organs made up of striated muscles and non-striated muscles. The learner can explain the structure of nerve cell. The learner can draw the diagram of nerve cell. So these are the learning outcomes in the topic, today's topic. Okay, before going to the lesson, let us recall the term tissue, the definition of tissue. What is tissue? Tissue is a group of cells that are similar in structure and functions. Tissue is a group of cells that are similar in structure and functions. Okay, let us recall how the organisms are formed. First of all, you know very well, the cells are the basic structural and functional units of the organism, both in animals or plants, or unicellular or multicellular organisms, whatever it, they contain the organisms or animals or plants or whatever it, they are made up of the cells. The cells are the basic structural and functional units. These cells form tissues, and these tissues form the organs, and organs form various types of organ systems, and organ systems form a organism or animal. It means the animal contain so many organ systems in the body. It means digestive system is there. If we take consideration of human being, there are so many systems are present in our body. The digestive system is there, nervous system is there, respiratory system is there, excretory system is there, muscular system is there, skeletal system, endocrine system. So many systems are there in the body. These systems are made up of the organs. For example, in the digestive system, there are so many organs are present, and these organs get constituted and form a system of organs. For example, mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum, anus. These are all the organs present in the digestive system. These organs are made up of tissues. These tissues are made up of cells. It means all the organisms are made up of cells and its components. So these tissues are a group of cells here. They are similar in structure and function. They are similar in structure and function. And these are cells, group of cells are called a tissue. Okay, here. Okay, today. We know about muscular tissue. The functions of muscular tissue in the body, they are helps in movement of hands and legs. We do so many activities in our daily life. They are helps in muscular tissue helps in movement of hands and legs, and increasing of decreasing the diameter of the blood vessels. And the muscle tissue are helps in movement of internal organ such as a heart or what do you call that, the stomach, the muscles of stomach, the movement of internal organs, and the releasing the energy. You know, the energy is released in the cellular level. So these cell, in these cells level, either it is in aerobic respiration or anaerobic respiration, the cells are the major sources of releasing of energy. It means the tissues are the sources of releasing of energy. And the pumping of blood. Blood pumps by a muscle tissue, a separate muscle, a separate organ, that is heart. So here, based on the structure, location and function, muscles are three types. They are the striated muscles, non-striated muscles, and the cardiac muscle. One is striated muscles. Muscles are grouped into three types based on the structure and functions. One is striated muscle, non-striated muscle, and cardiac muscle. Let us discuss in detail. Striated muscle. These muscles show alternate light and dark bands or striations. That's why they are called striated muscles. Here you can see alternate light and dark bands. Here the light band and the dark one. Light one and dark one. These alternate light and dark striations are present in the muscle. That's why it is called the striated muscle. And just watch the video here. The children are doing some activities. The children are doing exercise. They are moving their limbs. They are moving their legs and hands. We can move some muscles by our conscious effort. In the previous video, you observed the children are moving their hands and moving their legs. It means we can move our muscles, some of our muscles, by our conscious effort. We move according to our wish and will. Such muscles are called voluntary muscles. It means these muscles are, in the previous video, the children are moving their muscles voluntarily. So these muscles are called voluntary muscles. These muscles are also called as a skeletal muscles, because these muscles are attached to the bones and helps in body movements. That's why they are called the skeletal muscles. You know, striated muscles also called voluntary muscles and also called skeletal muscles. And next, non-striated muscles. Non-striated muscles, the cells are long with pointed ends and having a single nuclei, uninucleated. They are also called non-striated muscles. And non-striated muscles are involuntary muscles. It means these are not voluntary muscles. It means these muscles are not moving with our wish. These are involuntary muscles. These muscles, the movement of these muscles are not on our control. That's why they are called involuntary muscles. They are also found in gut, blood vessels, the iris of the eye, in uterus, and in the bronchi of the lungs. So you can see here, there are no striations in these muscles. That's why they are called non-striated muscles. And these non-striated muscles are not voluntary. They are moved involuntarily in the body. It means the movement of the muscles are not in our control. That's why they are called involuntary muscles. And here, next one is the cardiac muscle. All the muscles in the cardiac muscle, all the muscle cells in the cardiac muscle have striations. Here you can see the striations. Though they are called, resemble the striated in its structure, it is an involuntary muscle. They are look like striated muscles, but they are involuntary muscles. Both we can see, both characteristic of striated and non-striated muscles in the cardiac muscle. You can see here the striations here, and these are involuntary muscles. Cardiac muscles are, we can find the cardiac muscles in the heart. Heart is made up of cardiac muscle. And here you can see the muscle movement of cardiac, movement of cardiac muscle. Here you can see, this is the heart, how the heart is functioning here. Think, dear children, think what will happen if the function of the muscles of a heart will stop. What happened? Just think. And here, let us discuss the differences and the similarities of these muscles. Striated muscle, non-striated muscles, and cardiac muscles. Striations are present in the striated muscles. In the non-striated muscles, there are no striations. Striations are absent in the non-striated muscles. And cardiac muscle contains striations. Here, striations are present in the cardiac muscle. And striated muscle, voluntary muscle, this is also called the voluntary muscle. And the non-striated muscles are called the involuntary muscles. And the cardiac muscles are involuntary muscles. We can see the striated muscles in cells of the tissue are long, cylindrical, and unbranched, and multi-nucleated. There are so many nuclei are present in the cells, in the striated muscles. And non-striated muscles, the cells are long with pointed ends and uninucleated, means only one nucleus is present in the non-striated muscle cells. And cardiac muscle, the cells are long branched and have nuclei. The nuclei is present in the cardiac muscle. And here, striated muscles are present in the limbs. It means legs and heart, legs and hands. Non-striated muscles are present in the gut. Gut means elementary canal. It means digestive system, in the digestive system. And blood vessels. And uterus. Bronchi of the lungs. The organs contain the non-striated muscles. And the cardiac heart is contained the cardiac muscle. This is a specific muscle tissue which is only present in the heart, that is cardiac muscle. And let us go to next tissue, that is the nervous tissue. Before discussing about this nervous tissue, just think this question. How do you feel if you put your fingers in a glass of hot water? What happened? What happened if light is focused on your eyes? Just guess the children, what happened? What is the function of the nervous tissue? Where it is present? Just discuss the answers. In the nervous tissue, the major function of nervous tissue is receiving the information and giving and producing responses to the surroundings. That is the main function of nervous tissue. Here you can see the brain produce responses, and brain contain billions of nerve cells, and these tissues are called a nervous tissue and also called neurons. Billions of the neurons are present in the brain, and they are get together and form a nervous system, and their main function is giving the responses to the stimulus. Here, there are so many parts are present. There are the three parts are present in the nervous cell or neuron. One is the cytosol. Here is the structure. You can see the diagram on the screen. Here, this is nervous cell or neuron. These are billions of neurons are present in the brain and produce responses to the surrounding stimuli. And these neurons are contained three parts mainly. One is cytosol. Next one is axon, and third one is dendrites. You can see here the cytosol. This is the cell body. This is also called the cell body. And axon, this is a long tail-like structure is there here. This is axon. And here the branch-like, finger-like, branch-like projections are here arranged from the cytosol. These are called the dendrites. And some more parts. Here, nucleus, a large nucleus is present in the center of the cytosol and also contain a nuclei in itself. This is nucleus here. You can see here the nucleus. And so many, the granules are present in the cell body. These granules are called Nissl granules. You can see the dot-like structures in the cytosol. These granules are Nissl granules. Nissl granules, these are the specific structures which are present in only in the cytosol, in the nervous cell also. And another one, here is myelin sheath. Here the axon, this is the long tail leg structure, is the axon. This axon contains covered with a sheath or cover. That cover is called a myelin sheath. And this myelin sheath leaves some intervals, regular intervals or gaps here. These gaps are called the nodes of Ranvier. And also this axon ends with a branch-like structure. These structures are called nerve terminals. These are the main parts in the cytosol, in the nerve cell. So these nerve cells, again, I'm telling you, these nerve cells, billions of nerve cells are present in the brain and spinal cord. And they produce, they give responses. They take a stimulus and give responses to the surroundings. Here, let us discuss in detail about cytosol. Here, the diagram of cytosol. This cytosol is also called a pericardia, or also a cell body. And the Nissl granules are present in the cytosol. The presence of Nissl granules is the specific characteristics of cytosol. It is the center for all synthetic activity of neuron. It means it receives the information in the form of nerve impulses and analyze the information and produce the responses. It means all the synthetic activities are carried out by the cytosol. And also, it memorizes. They have the capacity of memory, like a SIM card we are using in our mobile phones, so like a SIM card. It is also memorize the information. It analyzes the information. It memorizes the information. All these synthetic activities are sources of, are present, are carried out by the cytosol. And here, dendrites. The finger-like projections arising from the cell body are called dendrites. These are the finger-like projections, branch-like projections are arising from the cell body. These are called the dendrites. These dendrites link another cytosol. They receive the information from other neurons and carry the information to the cell body. Here, they are interconnected with other neurons. And they receive the information from other neurons and they send the information to the cell body. And there are no Nissl granules in the dendrites. And the next part is that is axon. Each neuron have only one axon. Axon are also called the nerve fibers. This is a long tail-like structure is called axon. It is also called the nerve fiber. Cytoplasm of axon is covered with a plasma membrane. Here you can see. Axon gives a several branch-like structures are called nerve terminals. Ending of the axon, several branch-like structures you can see here. These are called nerve terminals. And axons are covered with a sheath. That sheath is called myelin sheath. myelin sheaths leaves some intervals. These intervals are called gaps, are called the nodes of Ranvier. Some of the nerve cells contain myelin sheath. They are called myelinated neurons. And some are doesn't contain the myelin sheath. They are called non-myelinated neurons. The function of myelin sheath is it prevents the leakage of electrical current from the axon. When the nerve terminals receive the information and process the information through to the cyton, this information in the form of electrical current, they are converted into electrical current. They are called also nerve impulses. These nerve impulses or electrical current is processed through the axon to cyton. When it passes through the axon to cyton, the myelin sheaths are covered, which are covered all over the axon, and they prevent the leakage of this electrical current. And next, let us recall, students, what we learnt in this class. Let us recall. Here, tissue is a group of cells that are similar in structure and functions. Based on their structure, location and functions, muscles are three types. They are one, striated muscle, two, non-striated muscle, and a cardiac muscle. Striated muscles are called voluntary muscles. Non-striated muscles are called involuntary muscles. Heart is made up of cardiac muscle. And neurons receive the information and generate the responses. These are the main functions of neurons. There are three distinct parts in the nerve cell or neurons. They are cell body, or cyton, axon, and third one is dendrites. Nerve cells are the only cells in the body which do not have the ability of regeneration. You know very well, regeneration. It means cell division is a common process in all cells. But there is no cell division process in the nerve cell. Nissl granules are present only in neurons. Okay, my dear children, I think you are understood this lesson, and this is a time of evolution. And try to get answers to these questions from your textbooks or our various sources. Okay, write the differences between striated muscles and non-striated muscles. Explain the structure of nerve cell. Give examples of various organs which are made up of striated muscles. Draw the diagram of nerve cell. What happens if myelin sheath is absent in the axon? Okay, my dear students, we'll meet with another topic in our another lesson. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.